control of the baby?
I you should ask Dr. Afif just now. He's got all the latest numbers. I just want to stress that we want to make Penang rabies free. So there's only been so far 2 cases. But I think we have to accept the advice from Veterinary Services Department. And we are only doing culling of strays. We're just culling of old dogs, just culling of strays. Because we have run out of vaccines. And when I asked the Department of Veterinary Science, why is it they don't have enough vaccines? They said that because Malaysia was declared rabies free since the 21st, since what, 1999. And that's why they don't keep vaccines, because we were rabies free. And to get the number of vaccines available will take some time. Until then, you just cannot sit back and do nothing. You are compelled to take some action, and that's why they've recommended culling, which I've accepted, since we don't have vaccines, not even enough for pet dogs, much less for strays. So this is something that we do not like to do, and but I think it is our public duty to look after public health. So we hope that this and we also have to stress that the culling is done in a humane manner. There are no shooting of dogs. They are all by injection and done in a humane manner. And that is also what is done. The humane method is done the same way as it's done in other countries where it's done in humane culling. So we hope that animal activists do not spread misinformation or false information by pinning the blame on about culling done in other states, because each state has their own culling methods. We do it the humane manner by tranquilizer. That's why the number of dogs culled is still very low, because we don't do by shooting the dogs, we do by tranquilizer injection. I think so far we have done probably around 600. Compared to police and Kedah, they are over 2,000 dogs. So we continue with that humane culling method. We are hopeful that we can contain the rabies outbreak, because apart from the 3 cases so far, there are no new cases. We're keeping our fingers crossed. But the number of us of reported dog bites has also gone up. But so far, we have not been able to identify whether they are rabies or not. I want to stress again that some of the pictures that are shown that allegedly linked to Penang, they are probably untrue. These are either old pictures, old video clips, some not in Penang, and most of them not in Penang, or sometimes not even in Malaysia. Not in Penang, not even in Malaysia, from other countries or from outside Penang. As I said, we don't do shooting. And ours is done in a humane manner. It is not an easy decision to make, but when you talk about public health, we don't have any other options. So you can ask me something related about this. Can I answer your question?
Political questions.
There's one question. There's one article written by Anthony. Anthony Tai Sagam. He's a wheelchair bound animal activist. I think that is a very reasonable article on this issue. It came out in the Malaysian Insider, the opinion page. Sorry?
I need to ask you.
What is it about?
Party members.
Party members.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, can we keep it on focused on GEMS education? That's what this meant. Thank you.
Okay, shoot, you can ask me later. So, except for the dog culling issue, I think if there are no more questions, then we'll adjourn the press conference.
Thank you very much, guys. Appreciate it. Thank you.